Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your weekly reading. This is your forecast for the week ahead, June 10th through the 16th, 2024. For all Taurus suns, moons, risings, Taurus is on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the second house or Venus in Taurus, feel free to watch this reading. And this is a general reading, so it may not resonate with everyone out there. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading with either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. Any information you may need, Taurus is down below in that description box or up in the right-hand corner. Just click that eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. For your reading today, I'm using two decks. The first one is this one here, which is the Manara Erotic Tarot by Lo Scarabeo. There's a QR code here on the back if you want to take a screenshot of that and click to get the guidebook, etc. And then for your oracle messages today, I'm using this deck here, which is the Oracle of Shadows and Light by Lucy Cavendish, artwork by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. Once again, there's a QR code on the back if you want to scan to download the guidebook or publisher information. Alrighty then. Don't forget to like the video, share the video, subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell so you always get notified whenever I upload a reading for you. And Taurus, let's go ahead and jump into the spread. We're looking at six cards for your week ahead. What are the most important messages and energies you have for the sign of Taurus, June 10th through the 16th? 2024. Give me six cards for their week ahead, please, Spirit. Taurus, June 10th through the 16th, please. And one more. See what we got for Taurus. Underneath the deck, we have the Two of Earth, Capricorn's energy, the Devil. Could be dealing with a Capricorn. We have a Moon in Taurus here, Six of Pentacles reverse. That's your energy, and the Eight of Fire. All right, so someone moved on here, and someone is definitely conserving their resources. There's some sort of broken agreement here, and this could be with a karmic, and I'm seeing someone drop the ball. I don't know what this is about, but this is an energy of overwhelm, feeling overwhelmed here, okay? By emotions or, you know, resources stretched thin. But let's see, how you see yourself today, we have the World. So, you are the Alpha and the Omega. This is the last card in the Major Arcana. It represents a completion of a cycle. It could be a Saturn cycle. This is also you wrapping up the loose ends here. It is also representing protection here and fulfillment, victory. This is winning the war, not just the battle. So, you have done something here really well. You've mastered a life lesson or something, but this is a very nice card. All right, so well done, Taurus. Your theme for the week ahead is the King of Fire in reverse, and this is Leo's energy. However, in the reverse position, I read this as Sagittarius. That's just how I read the card. So it is a Sagittarius here in your environment or your theme for the week. Now, if that's not the case, someone here could be love bombing someone here. This could be an energy that's very manipulative. This could also be someone that's very arrogant, lusty, and will basically rage and lust after someone. And so it's very fiery, but it's not using the fire in the right manner here. If that's not the case, you may be dealing with a Sagittarius or another fire sign. We'll have to clarify that. For your theme for the week, I don't know what's provoking this energy or if that's you or who. In the past, we learned a lesson regarding the Nine of Aqua in reverse. Well, something clearly did not meet your needs emotionally or from a pleasure standpoint. You were left feeling unsatisfied. You were left feeling disappointed or resentful. And this is Jupiter in Pisces here. So you did not get a wish fulfillment in the past here. So you learned a lesson regarding that. And now your challenge this week is the Priestess in reverse. So you may be dealing with a hidden enemy here. This could also be, you know, a challenge around someone that is very withdrawn, not listening to their intuition. This could be someone here that's very fake and artificial. You could be dealing with a Pisces. You could also just have a challenge around listening to your intuition this week and not putting on a facade or pretending that something is one way when it's another way. Okay. The lesson you're learning now is the One of Water, so Ace of Cups energy. This is a lesson regarding love, but not just any kind of love, unconditional love. All right, and once again, we'll have to go in and clarify that. This lesson regarding love for you this week, unconditional love, and your gift is the Judgment, Pluto energy. All right, so maybe you are giving someone another chance here. But there's definitely a final decision being made. This could be some sort of judgment from the court system, or this could be also just you accepting responsibility for the role that you play, the actions that you've taken that have led you to your current situation, and you're now ready to move forward here. So in other words, you are accepting of your karma and you're ready to move forward with a decision. Okay, final decision, no going back. You made up your mind on something here. So what is the High Priestess, or what is the King of Fire in reverse here? And we have the Ace of Earth, or the One of Earth in reverse. What is the Priestess in reverse here in the challenge position? The Four of Fire, Aries energy. And what is the One of Water as the lesson Taurus is learning this week? The Six of Fire, Jupiter and Leo. Okay, if this is someone else you're dealing with here, they're dealing with a rejection. And if this is you, then you may be dealing with a rejection here. And someone is not happy about this rejection. Someone has rejected an offer, or someone has turned something down, or it's not the right time. But this is causing someone to become enraged and very arrogant. Your challenge this week here has to do with listening to your intuition regarding your home or family or your living situation, or perhaps like your, I don't know, I guess if you have a YouTube channel, it could be having to do with your storefront or something. But this is something having to do with your home or family or your joy and stability here that's coming up. And now the lesson is regarding ultimately has to do with unconditional love, love and success. And what is really going to, what is true love and what is true success and recognition for that. Okay, that's very nice. Judgment, please clarify judgment. Three of Air. Okay, that's the answer I needed here. Okay, so your gift is Judgment and the Three of Air. So you're definitely giving something up here. You're definitely saying no to something. You're definitely going to be, this could be a sacrifice of some kind that you have to make. It is going to break someone's heart. I'm not saying it's going to break your heart, but it's almost like saying, like Taurus, when you choose to love unconditionally, when you love yourself here, you're winning. You're automatically going to win. But that may mean that you have to, someone else here is not going to have that opportunity, or something like that. But someone may be not the right fit for your home or family situation, or, maybe this could also be some sort of pretentious type of energy where it's like we're projecting the energy of a happy home and family when in fact, you know, it's really not that at all. Because you already learned a lesson here in the past. I guess what they're saying is choose you, Taurus. Choose you. All right, you're going to win when you choose yourself, when you put yourself first, always. Now, let me see here. What is the advice for Taurus this week? Three witchy sisters, the power of three. Now, interestingly enough, I saw the phrase, the grass is greener. So someone or a group of people, or maybe these are your family members, are going to try to convince you that the grass is greener on the other side, that you're not, they're going to try to convince you out of loving yourself or putting yourself first. And, but see, two of these witchy sisters have their eyes closed and one of them has their eyes open. And I sort of take that to mean like people are sleeping and two people are sleeping while one person is awake. And I kind of feel like you're the one that's awake here. Okay. Let's just pretend you're the one that's awake here. So if these are your sisters or whatever, you know, they may try to convince you that the grass is greener on the other side, but actually you're quite happy with what you have here. You're quite happy and successful loving yourself. And maybe this having a home and family and then having the white picket fence and all that stuff, it really looks great on the outside, but something here is just not. Like I'm just getting that you may have to reject an offer or you may have to piss someone off here, and that's okay, you know? Let's get one more. Can I get one more for Taurus here this week? Because we have the power of three. So something has to go here because we have the three of air, which is the three of swords. So ghosts of the past. The past returns for a time. Yeah, so you could have someone coming back. Are we in a Mercury retrograde? I don't know. Someone could come back here. I feel like whoever's coming back is a hidden enemy of yours, and you know this, and they don't have good intentions. So it may be worth looking into who that could be, but this could be a family member, it could be a sister, it could be someone that you've already closed out a chapter with here, and you don't really need to repeat this lesson. So that's what I'm getting for you this week, Taurus. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hope this reading did help someone out there. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel, any information you may need. Book a private reading down below in the description box or up in the right-hand corner. Thanks for watching.